Baba is, unless you have some kind of absolute knowledge. But again, it was the eyes. It was the eyes that drew me in the photos.
And why do you feel that way?
It's it's the gut and the heart and the head all together. And when my dad is, he's a huge atheist. Mention my dad here because he, as a person who has been on an atheistic journey and, you know, ended up studying religion and studying spirituality and anyway, that was my dad, but is my dad, that's who my dad is. And I think he bequeathed on me a skepticism, and I think a lot of people need to also, especially in the West, understand through the head as well as the heart and have that filter. And for me, it was also books. I came to Meher Baba through books. So whatever experience or question I have has to be squared intellectually. I know that's not, one doesn't find the truth through the intellect. But it has to be a whole truth, and I think that I don't want to talk about Persians because I don't know too much about it, but they have a place that's in the solar plexus that is that's God resides there.
The dill?
Yes, thank you. I didn't want to say that because I'm not an expert, but that's what I'm talking about. It's a place that I'm still trying to reach, I think, and it's not a physical place, but there are we live in the physical body and you have to reference your experience through the physical, and that would be probably the place if it were physical. But again, there's a heart brain connection that has to, you know, there has to be a communication between the head and the heart. I'm trying to remember a Baba quote. I don't think I can. But he does say, you know, when the mind slows down, the heart starts to work.
Mm-hmm.
And how do I know? I don't always. It's a work in process. I strive to know. Yeah. And again, we're on this earth. And I would like to experience and know God on this earth. Certainly, I would not look for him in any other place, because that's where we are. And so I would not say my knowing is through the senses, but I would hope and try to ground that knowing through my experience. I'm a little bit of a person who likes things to be experiential rather than, and I struggle with the concept of faith, as blind or held as an experience apart from, that's held in front of someone, you know, as a carrot on a stick, you know, that, you know, you walk through this path and you don't see God and you don't know God and you don't experience God, but you trust that he's there. I struggle with that. I like God to be right by my side. So how do I know? A very good way to think about ways of knowing is the Master's Prayer, because it affirms how God is everywhere and yet not there. And so it's a good question. It's a very good question, Laurent.
Thank you, Emily.